Max. Well, that didn't last long. Could these tweets compromise this settlement with the SEC?
Yeah, I mean, it's possible that the deal is not final, and you know, as part of the deal, Tesla is not supposed to sort of say that it, you know, dispute the general thrust of the accusation. This feels kind of like a borderline thing. I mean, you know, Musk could argue that he's just sort of making a dad joke or something, but it definitely feels like a company that's not fully in control. And one thing that's sort of strange about this whole thing is that Tesla's stock was actually doing pretty well. It's not as if the short sellers were hammering it or anything. Now this just looks like another self-inflicted wound.
And look, is this going to revive questions about his fitness to be running this company?
You'd have to think that some people are going to bring it up. I mean, especially, you know, considering the sort of nature of the tweets, where you have a bunch of them, and as you said, there's some sort of typos and things like that. Again, though, the problem here for Tesla and for the SEC is that Tesla doesn't, it's hard to imagine Tesla existing without Elon Musk. And a lot of the reason that customers are buying the cars, are fans of the company, has to do with this very colorful, you know, guy. And so it's hard to imagine the SEC saying, oh, well, now he has to step down as CEO, because that would, you know, that would probably hurt the value of the stock and ultimately hurt investors. On the other hand, when you have a situation where somebody, you know, is just sort of not listening to the thrust of what board members or regulators are saying, it's sort of hard to know where you go.
Now, a federal judge still has to decide whether the penalties that were agreed to are fair. You know, what do you imagine is happening behind the scenes with regulators right now, knowing the swiftness with which they moved to open this investigation in the first place?
Well, an article that my colleagues published earlier today, you know, said that basically, you know, you could imagine the SEC reading the Riot Act, at least to his lawyer, saying, hey, we really mean it now that you have to, you know, not call us the short seller enrichment commission. But again, beyond that, I'm not really sure. And so I guess you could imagine, you know, the SEC bring their lawsuit again and trying to get a deeper penalty. But who knows? I mean, hopefully, you know, from the point of view of Tesla investors, Elon Musk will basically stay off of Twitter. And yesterday we saw some of, you know, the biggest bulls basically tweeting at him, telling, you know, hey, settle down. Let's not, you know, throw a wrench in the machine right now.
Right, and recent history would show that would lead us to not expect that to happen. You've got earnings coming up in a month now. As you mentioned, the production numbers look good. Things were moving in the right direction. What does Tesla have to do in the next few weeks to get to sort of point A, from point A to point B?
Well, I mean, in the next few weeks, I mean, they have to just keep the production going, and we don't really know, you know, whether they, you know, what exactly they did to get those production numbers to look so good. Maybe, you know, they had, or, you know, they maybe were throwing tons of people at it. I mean, what they need to do is make those cars sustainably. And I guess the other important thing, and at this point, now that the production stuff is figured out, it's maybe more important, is that they need to sell these cars and get them delivered. And again, we've been seeing these kind of reports about various sort of delivery problems or issues with customer service. And then there's also just sort of the long-term question of, will people who've expressed interest in buying this thing, will they then pony up? We've seen Tesla, you know, throwing out all these incentives, including, you know, free supercharging. Recently, there was a promise that they would send a little picture into space for Tesla customers. So they're trying all sorts of things to sort of get, you know, make sure that demand is there as production ramps up. And if they're able to do that, I mean, then this looks like a very successful car company. It looks like a company that is, you know, has a car that's, you know, on the level of the biggest mass market cars, at least in the United States.